Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on current sense amplifiers. My name is Constantin Negrelli, and I'm an applications engineer in the current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will continue our discussion on debug with a focus on issues that may occur when interfacing with other circuitry. As noted in other videos, there are several inherent device error sources. This video of our series focuses on user errors, in particular, those that occur when interfacing with other devices and system components. To start off, let's begin with this case where we have an INA190 with a 200 volt per volt gain and are attempting to measure 900 milliamps across a 10 milliohm shunt. According to our calculations, our output should be 1.8 volts. However, a quick glance at a single ADC reading shows our measurement is off. This is a larger difference than a typical device error. So as usual, we probe around to see what the problem might be. We start by probing at the input pins and find that our shunt voltage is 9 millivolts, which means our load is what we expect it to be. We then decide to probe at the output and find that we get exactly what we expect, 1.8 volts. Consequently, we revisit our ADC measurement. This time, we plot with respect to time, or sample count. From this closer inspection, we notice that our measurement exhibits oscillatory behavior centered around our value of interest. At this point, we begin to suspect that perhaps the output capacitance might be too high, thereby creating an instance of instability. So we pull up the data sheet, and to our confusion, find that the load cap is well within spec. Additionally, our filter resistance is large enough to also make this seem unlikely as the case. So what is going on here? Well, in our previous slide, you may have noticed that we are sampling at 1 MHz. For a SAR ADC like the ADS7953 to work, a device with high bandwidth should be used to interface with the ADC. A high bandwidth helps to replenish the charge bucket capacitor between samples. As you can tell from this table taken from our datasheet, the INA190's bandwidth is relatively low for all gain variance compared to the sampling frequency of 1 MHz. So naturally, you might ask, how do I fix this issue? You can either reduce your sampling rate, change your RC output filter, or put a buffer with a high bandwidth between the current monitor and ADC. In our case, we chose a buffer with an OPA365 and were able to get the measurement shown here. We recommend watching the following video from the ADC team to better understand this issue and learn about the tools they provide for helping you select the best option for interfacing with an ADC. We also recommend reading the Current Sense Amplifier Considerations for Driving SAR ADC's application report. So it's possible you may want to measure the current in multiple locations and sum the values together, perhaps due to price, common mode, or solution size, you may use different current shunt monitors for different parts of your system. In this particular instance, we have an INA169 performing a high side measurement for a common mode that falls outside of the INA190's absolute max range. To sum the INA169 and INA190 measurements together, we decide to just use a non-inverting summing amplifier topology. According to our calculations, we expect to see about 1.256 volts on the TLV9302 output, with the majority of this value summing from the INA169 measurement. However, after simulating, we get something less than ideal. Could this just be an artifact of a bad simulation model? No, let's take a closer look at how these current shunt monitors work. Unlike the INA190, which would be classified as a voltage amplifier, the INA169 is a transconductance amplifier which increases the output current with respect to the input sense voltage. Consequently, the loading on the output has a significant impact on what voltage is observed. If we account for the summing amplifier's 10 kiloohm resistors and the INA190's output voltage of 6.28 millivolts, we calculate an expected output of 559 millivolts, which is close to our simulated value and likely reasonable when we account for the error sources, such as offset and gain error. So now that we know what the issue is, how do we fix it? One method would be to buffer the INA169 output. By doing this, the buffer amplifier serves as a high impedance that renders the output impedance equivalent to be 25 kiloohms. This then leads to roughly the same voltage we had in our initial calculations. Another method with a footprint improvement would be to place a buffer on the INA169 and have the output feed into the INA190 ref pin. This allows you to sum the measurements and reduce your BOM count. In summary, checking downstream circuitry is an important step to the debug process. It may not seem like a likely culprit in causing issues, but knowing what to look out for will help avoid these pitfalls. When interfacing with an ADC, it is important to understand the output limitations of the current sense amplifier and the needs of the ADC to capture accurate measurements. When working with transconductance amplifiers, it is necessary to account for downstream resistances, especially when trying to use them in conjunction with other circuitry. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on current sense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/currentsense.